Hey everybody, Bill here, Rust Stewart Hot Rods. Well, round two. Gotta take everything apart inside, underneath the hood. So, all the, steady camera, side here. And we got the, over here is all the hydrovac stuff. We got a discombobulate, carburetor linkage. This, that, and everything else. There are radiators already out of it. So, shouldn't be too tough. And I'm not even gonna try to save the wiring. That all goes bye-bye, it's gonna get rewired. So let's get started on it.
Thank you.
Oh, sunshine, what a concept. You like it, Hazel? What do you think? Is it good? Good girl. Well, getting ready to lift the body off. I'll show a little bit of preparation before I get to it. But I'm no close. So this is how I have it set up. The pole. So I ran some, made some wood braces here, some supports down below to catch the rockers, which are, they're excellent. They're in great shape. And raise it up with this camper jack, which works really well. Everything's unbuttoned, ready to go. I got a good camper jack to get set up on this side. And we'll get started. One motor mount sticking. There it is.
Thank you.
got to drop that much farther in the back. It's all about the center wheel well lining up. Looks like the body's got to go forward, huh?
Well, you can always move it later.
Did my little FYI segment. If you're not familiar with these camper jacks, this is what we used to use, you know, back in the 80s, I guess, to take campers off your pickup truck. Back when campers were made out of wood and spit and glue. And they worked really well. They hold a lot of weight. Used to get a little unstable with the campers. That's why I picked the truck up with a three-point stance. Had a hitch, the cherry picker in the front, and that worked out really well. Nice and stable. But I'm going to end this video here. Appreciate it. See you later. Take care. Subscribe if you would.